this one, and this one threw me because it says photo of Evar, and I wasn't sure what they were talking about. Laureen looked at that and said, I don't know. You know, she was thinking the same thing I was, but when I went and looked at the question, then I remembered. And what this says, this was a pretty cool one. This one actually came in from a student, and I'll end up clicking on this link as well. And she said, I ended up searching online, and she ended up downloading this article. And here's the link. But before we go, that's right, I want to go back and forth. Before we go to the link, let's scroll down. I want to show you these pictures, and I want to go over some of the words that I did first. So what an AVAR is actually a repair, an aneurysm repair. And this is an abdominal aneurysm here. This is the stent graft that they put in right there, okay? And this shows you, you know, outside the kidneys where this is. And this is showing you what the aneurysm would look like, you know, before the repair. And then they put the repair in there. And it does, it looks like with all these ziggy lines. Okay, now this is showing you, like, how they would go in and do this. This middle picture. And how they would go in through the femoral artery to do that and put the repair in. And then here is actually a live shot of them doing that in the OR. Okay, pretty intense. Okay, there were some terms that you needed to know. And some of these you may know and some of you may not know. But this first one, fenestration, is actually in the code book, so you needed to know this, a natural or surgically created opening in a surface. Okay, fenestration. Aneurysm, you may or may not know what that is, an abnormal blood-filled bulge of a blood vessel and especially an artery resulting from weakening as from disease of the vessel wall. Okay. And then this other word, this endoprosthesis, an artificial device to replace a missing bodily part that is placed inside the body. Okay, that's different. That's not a word that we all know very well. Okay, so the codes that we're going to look up for this procedure, this AVAR, is going to be 34841 and 34845. And it's an endovascular repair of visceral artery, and then it's aneurysm, pseudoaneurysm, dissection, penetrating ulcer, blah, 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 it goes on, by deployment of a fenestrated visceral aortic endograft and all associated radiological supervision and interpretation, including target zone angioplasty when performed, including one visceral artery endoprosthesis, and it says superior meniteric celiac or renal artery. Now, in between here, you know, we've got 34841, then you've got 34842, 43, 44, and then we've got 45. In between here, the difference between those to get you to 45 is that it's going to say, this is including one visceral artery, the next one's two visceral arteries, three visceral arteries, four visceral arteries or more, okay? I just didn't want to copy all of those. Now, this other code, 34845, endovascular repair, this almost reads exactly the same, okay? But you get down here and it says you've got traumatic disorder, okay, with a fenestrated visceral aortic endograft and concomitant unibody or modular infrarenal aortic endograft and all associated radiological supervision and interpretation, including target zone angioplasty when performed, including one visceral artery endoprosthesis, superior mesenteric celiac or renal artery. And then again, there's additional codes that 34844. 534846, 34847, and you can look at those to compare what they add. Now, this article, now that we know the terms and we know what they are, I'm gonna go ahead and click on this article that Laureen brought up for us, and this shows actually a procedure, endovascular aneurysm repair using branched or fenestrated device. Again, those terms that we didn't know. And then in detail, he talks about doing this. He gives all of these great pictures of them going in and performing this procedure. And then it gets real in depth with these pictures. It's amazing. And the student found this. And then another thing that I found that was truly amazing is, look, he gives a series of photos showing the technique of fenestrated grafting. And I didn't know this, but this graft here that they're showing the pictures of, these actually have little spurs on the inside of them when you're reading the article. And so it grabs the artery. It was just amazing. You know, you're thinking about how delicate the artery is itself, but it has little spurs that grab the artery tissue so that it doesn't let go, the stent. Anyway, amazing. Go in and look at that. That'll be on the replay club that you guys will have access to. And but you can put in endovascular aneurysm repair using branched or fenestrated device to see that. Amazing, amazing how they do that. So EVAR is actually an endovascular repair of an artery.
Need more medical certification training? Go to www.codingcertification.org.